Amen. And they wondered. And they wondered. Amen. Praise God. And the world wondered after the beast, after the Antichrist. They wondered after him. They were in awe. They were amazed at the things that he can do. The intellectual words that he can speak, the eloquence of his style, the distinguishedness of his persona. Amen. His knowledge base was extensive. He could communicate with everybody and anybody all over the planet. He was able to do things that no president and no leader was able to do, and bring peace to the Middle East. He was able to accomplish that goal. Take care of the food shortage. They wandered after him because they were so intoxicated with his wine, they could not see straight. They was calling good evil and evil good. Why come against this man? This is the savior of the world. This is the one that's bringing everything together. We got peace now where there was confusion, where there was war. There is no more war. But what does God say? When men say peace, sudden destruction is going to hit you. There is the backside, because there's a wrath on the inside of this Antichrist. There's a wrath against this world. There's a wrath that he can't contain. It's like a burning inferno. It's like a towering inferno. Amen. That's burning and that's waiting to be manifested. And he can't hold it back. He can only hold it back and shroud it for so long. But it's such a rage against God's people and against God himself that he can't contain himself, that he has to become exposed, that it has to be revealed, that it has to manifest. That's how powerful he is on the inside of this Antichrist. He can't hold him. He can't contain himself any longer. Amen. Praise God. And so the world wondered after the beast, and they worshiped the dragon, which gave power unto the beast. And they worshiped the beast, saying, who is like unto the beast? Who is able to make war with him? See how great and how high and how prominent this man is? Thoughts in their mind. God has given us pre-thoughts of the future. He's given us previews to pre-thoughts in the future. Y'all, God, I never said that before. Amen. Praise God. He's telling us what men are thinking in the future. And they wandered after him. And they're saying within their thoughts, who can make war with him? He has such an influence. He has the military behind him. He has the church behind him. He has the government behind him. He has the political arena behind him. He has the news media behind him. Who can make war with him? Who can stand up against him? And they wondered. And remember, they're saints now being saved. People are coming under the influence of salvation because now he's sent to make war. Let's check this out. I'm almost done. And there was given unto him a mouth speaking great things and blasphemy, and power was given unto him to continue 42 months. And he opened his mouth in blasphemy against God, to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle and them that dwell in heaven. So, are we not the tabernacles of God?
Amen.
Are we not his temples? So not only is he against God, he's against the temples. I'm telling you, he's against the temples, and he's against those that are in heaven. Amen, praise God. Amen. And it was given unto him to make war with the saints. So if he's making war with the saints, saints must be around during that time. That's why I told you that just because the church is gone doesn't mean that people still can't get saved. Okay? So he's making war with the saints. His intentions are to take the saints out. What Satan's tactics, what his tactics are, is to get the saints at their infant stages before they come to this point in the tribulation. Because this is tribulation time right now that he's being exposed and doing all these great works. The saints are already gone. So what he wants to do before they get to this point, he wants to give them that shot, that strong delusion, that goal. Y'all, see what I'm saying? He's trying to catch them ahead of time. Amen. He's trying to get them deluded ahead of time before they come to this point. And he's trying to discourage a lot. Amen. Praise God. Through the cares and affairs of this life to get you caught up. Because it's the cares and affairs of like thorns and thistles that choke the word out of you. If you don't got no word in you, your foundation is now turning from solid rock to stubble. Solid rock to sand. It's starting to crumble. And when your foundation crumbles, when he takes away that which your life is dependent on, y'all gotta catch that. When he takes away that which your temple is standing on, that it's rooted on, your house can't stand. It's shifty. It'll move with every temptation, with every wave and doctrine, with every enticement. You'll move to the to the right, move to the left. You want to be stable.
Amen.
Then you hit a mudslide, a landslide, wash your whole house away. Everything else you got, be gone. This is what Satan tactics are. Hope y'all can see this now that's happening. Amen. I'm almost done. And he opened his mouth in blasphemy against God to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle and them that dwell in heaven. And it was given unto him to make war with the saints and to overcome them. And power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations. You see how powerful this man is? All kindreds, tongues, and nations. He's given power over the whole world. This is the Antichrist, the last ruler of this world. Amen. He is the last Gentile ruler of this world. Because after him, amen, here comes Christ. He's going to rule for 1,000 years. Okay? And Christ is majestic. He's angelic. He's powerful. Spiritual. Okay? He's not human no more. That's gone. Okay? He's not coming back like a little baby's wrapped in swaddling clothes. He's coming back on his horse of war. Holiness on the side, on the girdle. King of kings and Lord of lords, that crown. He ain't coming back as no little baby talking about, can you got room for me in the end? No, I'm going to make my own end. Bam! Jerusalem is going to be my end. That's what I'm setting up headquarters at. Amen, praise God. You see, so he's not coming back playing games with nobody this time. He's coming back with a sword drawn, leading 10,000 of his saints. It's war time. Shouting hallelujah, the victory. Oh, y'all got it. Man, hallelujah, glory to God. And it says, and all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundations of the world. If any man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here is the patience and the faith of the saints. Amen. Praise God. Let's give God some hands.